Let's give them a round. Okay, so I'm going to just take a quick minute and I will come up. Hey guys, we're going to introduce our special guest. Anna Aranda is an incredible agent. I believe you're up in the St. Louis market, right?
Yep.
And today she's going to be talking about referrals, building relationships, and referral business. And she's very highly leveraged. If any of you are looking for leverage, this lady, I think, has mastered it. So we are so looking forward to it. I'm going to turn it over to Taylor Davis, who's going to be asking you questions and helping you through commentary. And let's give her a warm welcome and thank you for doing this time.
How are you doing today? Hey,
Taylor. I'm great. Thanks for having me.
Good. Good to see you. Thank you for so much for being a part. We appreciate that. So, expert in leverage and repeat referral clients, and then, if I'm not mistaken, referrals from other agents as well. Is that correct?
If you say so.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about, well, let me ask you this. Out of those topics, building a repeat referral business and leverage, which do you feel most confident to talk about starting off?
Oh, gosh, I could talk for how long you have.
We have now.
No, actually, how long do you have? I had asked, but I didn't know what the answer was.
Yeah, I mean, we usually about 45 minutes, and then we'll do
okay. Okay, great. So I think probably the most inspiring, as we're coming up on family reunion in about 2 months, holy cow, can you believe it? It's right around the corner. So maybe agent to agent referrals. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about sort of how I monetize that, how I focus. I'm really a keep it simple girl. It is so simple if you're focused and you do keep it simple. So I find that most agents overcomplicate. And I am the keep it simple girl.
Okay. So how do you keep that simple?
Number one, I think my proudest accomplishment, if you don't mind me saying, is I've been married for almost 40 years to my college sweetheart. We have two great kids, Peter and Talia. They're 31 and then, 24, 8 years later. We always call it, we're like, you're an oops. I mean, the best oops ever, but you're an oops. Family is super, super important to me. And so the way that I keep it simple is keeping that in front of me all of the time. It is the most important thing, hands down. There isn't even a close second. So Mark King is my business partner, and he's always asking me to talk about my passions in real estate. And I'm like, wait, you spelled family wrong. You know, if you're focused on whatever is the one thing for me, it's family, absolutely, positively, for sure. So it makes me a really razor sharp agent, but family is definitely it. Another thing is we've made 16 international moves before settling here in 2007 in St. Louis. And so being able to step into my clients' shoes, we do a lot of relocation. I run a really heartfelt business. And so I'm also a DC that kind of masquerades as an I on the disc. So hopefully that makes sense to you, by the way. Maybe making statements that make no sense. That's always great for the audience. But I'm a very much a get it done girl and then get it done right. And so the rest of you are cheerleaders. And so that's really, really, really helpful, is figuring out what works and then how it works better and quicker and faster and stronger, and then contributing to others. What I have learned over the many, many, many years is a real passion of mine, for sure. That would be my passion.
So when did you get into real estate?
So I've been in the business for 30 plus years. I've been with Keller for 17 years.
17 years. So when you landed in St. Louis, that would be when you started with KW, or was it, I guess it was right before that.
Yeah. No, it was when we, I've been here for 17 years and I actually was planning to join another company. And I met with the proprietors, the people who owned it. It was a local company. And they were fighting in front of me. So I realized I didn't want to go there. And Keller, of course, in total culture, Keller culture was inviting me to things. And oh my gosh, you know, I went golfing with them and went scuba diving with them. I've just all kinds of really cool stuff. They kept inviting me to do stuff. And I ended up putting my license there.
So you mentioned family is your why. Articulate that a little bit. Like, how is that your driving force? How do you keep that focus?
Golly, that's a good question. So I don't know. It just is. So I am married to absolutely the man of my dreams. And I think one of the things is, so I'm going on 60. I'm in my late 50s. So I think perspective becomes very important, especially the older you get. So we are travel enthusiasts and family enthusiasts. Our family goes everywhere with us. Literally, my goal is, so my daughter's getting married next year. And literally, I have $250,000 set aside for her wedding. The minute she met this boy, I was like, oh, I think she's going to marry him. And so that's what I mean by like family focus. Okay, so what do we need to do to make that happen, to make that a real wow experience for them, something they'll never forget because they better be married forever. But hopefully that helps.
Okay, so talk to us about your referral business and how you built that.
Golly. So I kind of go, can I say ass? I kind of go into things ass backwards. I don't go in with these great ideas. However, I really know a great idea when I see it. So you know how, even I'm sitting here talking to you guys. If you learn something today, pass it on to someone else. And if you hear of a great idea and I can help you with implementing it, please let me know. And then take one thing away that you're willing to implement, that is interesting to you, and that you're willing to implement from today. And so, I'm sorry, you asked a question and I got off on a tangent there.
Just the referral business.
Business. Okay.
What was the idea? You said you're good at identifying a good idea. So what was it?
Yeah. So the first agent-to-agent referral I did was probably 26 years ago, and real estate's a local business, but I move every year. So it's like, oh crap. So I realized that I could build a business with the advent of the internet that anyone could keep in touch with you and find you on the World Wide Web, right? And so I realized that that could be a huge part of my business if I contributed enough to other people. And so my clients would started to ask me for referrals to like Pittsburgh. I'm moving to Pittsburgh. Who do you know? You know, and I'm living in like Hawaii. And so I realized very early on that that could be a huge part of our business. What I didn't realize when I joined Keller is that we are actually a family. I didn't realize that at all. So my agent to agent referral business exploded when I came to Keller. Exploded. And it's just like anything else. It's about consistently implementing stuff. What I'd like to talk to you guys about is an implementable strategy that you guys can maybe take away and put into play this week if it's interesting to you. So I do three things really, really well. Taylor, can I talk to you about those three things that I do every single day in my business? Yeah, and I'm all about actionable. And so I also am happy to take any questions that you have as I'm going along if I'm not making sense. So I do three things to lead generate, and it is both with strategic alliance partners as well as agent to agent referral partners. So those three things are, I make 25 gratitude calls a day. I write 10 handwritten notes a day, and I comment on 20 of my SOI's social media posts. Now, a comment is not yes or a thumbs up or a heart. That's not a comment, right? Can we all agree that's not a comment? So I write at least a sentence less than five, more than one sentence. So if you go to my Facebook page, for instance, because I'm almost 60, so I pretty much use Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat a bit every day. So maybe that's more than others, but Facebook is really how I generate most of my business. And so all three of those things, 25 gratitude calls. I'm going to walk you through what one of those looks like. And then 10 handwritten notes and 20 comments on social media. Those are the only three things that I do every day, and they're done before noon. I don't do anything else. And usually they're done by 10 a.m., by the way. But I give myself till noon, like in case other stuff comes up. Or like right now, I threw my back out. So I'm actually really hurting. I did way, way, way too much this weekend. And so my days are looking a little bit different, like yesterday and today. Can I tell you what the gratitude call looks like?
Absolutely.
Hi, William. Welcome. Somebody just, I don't know why, but my screen just blanked out. Can you guys see me?
Yes, I can see you.
Okay, that was very interesting. Anyway, so the gratitude calls sound something like this. So Taylor, I'm going to role play with you real quick.
Good.
You ready?
Yep.
Okay, so ring, ring, ring.
This is Taylor.
Hey, Taylor, it's Ann Aranda with Keller Williams in St. Louis. Thanks for taking my call.
You bet. What can I do for you?
Right on. So I'm just calling to say thank you.
You're welcome. What for?
Yes. Every single person says you're welcome or what for or what I do now or, you know, depending on their level of humor, every single person says, what are you calling to thank me about? And so then I can jump into whatever it is that I'm calling to thank them about. So in this case, Taylor, I really appreciate the opportunity to present to your Norman office. And, you know, without you, I wouldn't be in front of these folks and inspiring. And I'm just super excited to do that and wanted to say thank you. And it's really that simple. It's a 30-second conversation. It's not a conversation about the dog or real estate sales. It's not anything like that. It's just whatever you're grateful for at the time. I would say about 90% of the time, folks take my call. In today's world, is that bizarre?
Extremely.
Very bizarre. I'm shocked myself every day. It's a lot of fun running around saying thank you and expressing gratitude all day long. And then the second piece is, you know, you're impacting other people's lives as well. Those 25 gratitude calls, do you have any questions around that? Or more like, what are your objections? Why couldn't you do that?
Okay, so what are some limiting beliefs in the room on why you wouldn't do that?
I don't know what to thank them about.
Okay. We don't know what to thank them about.
Well, you could call me once we hang up and say thank you for presenting today. You call Taylor, you call Stephanie. Missy Webb is the reason I'm here today. She's a close personal friend. You can call Missy, you can call Patrick with the title company. So that's six right there.
Wow.
Okay.
Who are you sitting next to right now? You know, you can call them. Same goes for the handwritten notes. You can call your husband or wife. I call my kids every single day and I say thank you. And they say, what for? It's a game. It's fun. It's super, super, super fun. Of those 10 handwritten notes, three go to my family, my two children, and my husband every single day.
Oh, wow. How awkward was it to get started doing this?
Zero awkward. Do I look like an awkward person? So here's the thing. Here's the really, really big thing is there's a side benefit here, and that is you're always in gratitude. You're always looking for people to say thank you to. So all day long, that's all I'm doing. I don't have any time for drama. I don't have any time for anything else because all I'm thinking about is who am I going to say thank you to right now and who am I looking to recognize and be grateful for? So when in doubt, just say thank you. That's a huge adage of mine. There is no downside. There is no downside at all. And so I have to ask you, are you honestly worried about what you would say in terms of thank you? And is there too much gratitude in people's lives? I will say human nature says there's not enough of things. That's just so not true. There is enough of everything. And because you give away gratitude, guess what you get in return?
Oh, gratitude.
Right. And abundance, et cetera, et cetera. So just practice it. Most people will say, how could 25 people, which I think was one of the objections, is who do I call? So what do I say is just thank you for whatever it is that you're calling them about. So that's super, super simple. It doesn't have to be difficult. It is a one sentence is enough, by the way. Who do I call? And so make a list. It's just like our bold exercises. You could call every one of your strategic partners. I call my stager almost every day. I talk to my title people and I have nicknames for them. Like our processor's name's Amanda. Do you want to guess what I call her?
Amazing Amanda.
I do, but it's not just Amazing Amanda. Wait, it's better. It's better. And she's like, she comes to my house for Sunday dinners, et cetera, et cetera. I'm at a cookie exchange next week. Every one of these people is coming. They all get invited. Whether they can come or not during the holidays is a whole different story. But literally pick 25 people, and it could be the same 25. I have about the referral sources for me are a couple of dozen. And then there's a whole bunch of ancillary referral sources that'll send you one off every once in a while. But those 25 people or so send me over 500 referrals every year.
Okay.
Wait, what?
Woohoo!
Wait. So a dozen people send you
two
dozen people send you approximately 500.
Yes.
Girls.
Yes.
That's maximizing your 80-20. So
yes,
how often?
And so I don't worry about anyone but really the 25. By the way, that's the focus. So I can spend all my time with my family.
Okay, and these are agents across the United States that are sending you referrals, or are these local to your market friends, family that are sending you a referral? Or
is
both?
That a trick question? The answer is yes.
Okay.
You spend the time with the people who are your biggest advocates. And it can be strategic partners, it can be family, it can be friends, past clients, agents. Don't discriminate. And here's a kicker. So this is something I haven't said. I give at least three times more than I receive. So that's really important. Come from contribution, and people will take your thank you calls, be grateful back, always be looking for opportunities for you.
So
always, they'll always be looking for opportunities for you. They're your biggest cheerleader. Missy Webb is one of my biggest cheerleaders, and vice versa.
Woo-hoo.
Is she there? I can't see.
She was the one that guessed Amazing.
Where are you? You're kidding. Oh, we probably talked about it. She and I have been sleeping together. She was in St. Louis 6 weeks ago. I'm kidding. We're not sleeping together. Anyway, just one of the biggest supporters, just an amazing, amazing, amazing person. Wow. So thank you, Missy. You're quite something. And I think I see you in between those two posts. Yep, there you are. Okay.
Right good.
Taylor, that's awesome. I need to screenshot that. There's Missy.
So do you have that strategic pause after you say thank you to wait for them to say something before you go?
Of course.
Okay. Tell us a little bit more about that. What's the strategy behind that?
There isn't one. I'm just calling to say thank you.
And there's
you mean the pause?
Awkward pause there? I'm like, there was with me.
Oh, sure. But it's not awkward for me. So as long as I'm happy. Sorry, but like, I mean, life's awkward, but most people I'm calling over and over and over again, Taylor. So they're like, what the heck are you calling to thank me about today? It becomes a big running joke, right? And so, no, but they don't screen your calls. They take your calls. I ask them to, and I ask them, what can I do for you in return at the end of the call today, this week, this month, 2022? I want to be your go-to for anything I can help with. Please let me know how I can help you in return. And so, you know, it's the same people over and over again. There's some new ones and some of them are awkward. I didn't say I was awkward. And so you always pause. That pause is going to be what for? That is going to be the response.
Okay.
For sure. Every single time. So you want it to be, I want it to be interactive.
Okay. And then, so you say thank you, they say what for, you say why. They say thank you in return, and then you ask them, what can I do for you in your business, or for you, or what can I do for you this week, this month?
You got it.
And then they say, I'm good, or here's what you could do, and that's the end of that. Is that correct?
That's correct. And so after about the third or fourth thank you call to the same person, they're ready for you and they're going to ask you for help, but they won't ask you at first. That's a deeper relationship. They're going to be like, oh, nothing. Ha ha ha. Right. You know, and so it's really about deepening relationships. They go deeper and deeper. So I'm not a very wide person, but I am a very deep person. And so that's the keep it simple, focus on family, et cetera. Because you go deep, you don't have to be very wide.
Okay.
And if you have Missy in your corner, oh my goodness, right?
Yes. So if you, okay, well, let's move on to the, any other questions on this? Cool. Let's move on to part two, the handwritten note. Is that where you want to go next?
Sure. Very actionable. So my note cards, this is, okay. Oh, by the way, I didn't make any of this up. Can I give you a resource for finding all of this information?
Please.
Yes.
Okay, it's a book. I was an early reader of the book, and when I read and started implementing things from this book, these are three strategies from the book, there are 117, I tripled my business that year. The book is called 7 Levels of Communication, Go From Relationships to Referral. It's by another realtor, Michael Mayer. He's in our Atlanta Keller Williams family. And so the gratitude calls, I'm going to go backward for a second. The gratitude calls are, by the way, if you text me, I'll send you a link to the book. So let me give you my number. And if you want to just text me real quick, I'll just respond to everyone. And by the way, put your contact information in there so I can save you to my database. But I will send you a link to the book. And the gratitude calls, in the book, it's called The Great Retrace. I've just totally bastardized it for my own purposes, but it is called The Great Retrace. The 10 handwritten notes are called Power Notes. And then I guess the comments on social media are a part of the book, but it's not a specific strategy. It's not really a specific strategy. But anyway, Michael Mayer, M-A-H-E-R, 7 Levels of Communication, Go From Relationships to Referral. We call it 7L, by the way. That's why I keep looking at my notes, because I don't know what the book's called. It's like 7L. These are the handwritten note cards that I use every single time. And the reason for that is my logo is a sunflower. Do you see my name and contact information on these?
No.
Do you see it here?
Mm-hmm.
I don't use business to generate business. It just comes naturally. So one of the things about this book, and I was so freaked out. I'm like, there's no way I cannot put my information on these cards. Michael asked that you pick something that is your logo. Mine is a sunflower. I'm kind of a sunny person. And so, and then I put a couple of little silly quotes on them. I mean, I've had these probably for 15 years. I've never changed them. People carry them in their wallet. They put them on their bulletin board. It's crazy. They're called power notes. You should really read up on them. But basically, you don't say the word I or me or we or us in the note. It is all about edifying the other person. It is, again, sort of a gratitude note. And so just as a reminder, I'm always looking for somebody to be grateful for. So that's the kicker of all this, is you're always edifying others, looking for the goodness in others. So guess what your whole life becomes? One big ball of goodness and opportunity. It's really incredible what you draw to yourself when you stay in gratitude and abundance and opportunity. And it's not really human nature. Human nature is kind of fear or abundance, most of it's fear. And so it is a really great way to indoctrinate yourself into abundance. And then the 20 comments on social media, I just kind of fell into that because, I did it once and it was like, I had this whole string of a conversation with somebody that I hadn't seen in years who was on a cruise ship and she was wearing like a pretty pink dress. So I was like, what a gorgeous dress. Where are you guys? And I sold 3 houses with her that year. And her mom's best friend is one of my strongest real estate competitors. And she picked me to sell a house based on starting that conversation when she was on a cruise. I'm like, hey, I might have fallen into something here. You know, so again, knowing a good thing when you see it and then repeating it over and over and over again. So I'm talking about 3 things that I do every single day that I work. By the way, I only work 3 days a week.
Can we get on?
Oh, yeah. Can we pass out your number real quick?
636-236-6646.
Lots of sixes.
a 666 right in there.
Will you repeat that one more time?
636-236-6646.
And then, okay, so you do the 25 gratitude calls. You do the 10 thank you notes where you're not using. So you're not saying I'm grateful for da 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 because you're not using it.
Correct.
Just so much for blah blah blah.
Well, it's not necessarily a gratitude note, although that's pretty much what it is. And so it may be. So say I'm writing one to you, Taylor. Again, thank you for having me on. I really appreciate it. So I wouldn't say, thank you for having me on. I really appreciate it, would I? Because it's got the word I in it. So I would say something like, you know, your incredible generosity in having me on, talk about it, whatever you all call it, sorry. What is this called again?
Talk about it Tuesday.
Right. Sorry about that. It goes so fast. I'm like, yeah, that's not right. Anyway, your incredible generosity and having me on Talk About It Tuesday between Missy, Stephanie, and yourself, the abundance attitude is through the roof. Look forward to seeing you at family reunion in 76 days, but who's counting? And I say love because I kind of love everyone. So I use that word a lot. I say I love you to my clients when I hang up. I'm kind of creepy. Y'all should come hang out with me. It's pretty weird. I literally do. And so that's what a note card would look like. At the bottom, there's always a PS. And I say something like PS, give me a call. There's an idea I want to discuss with you. And I put my phone number. And so my response rate on that has my phone ringing off the hook. So I do at least 30 a week, right? 10 handwritten notes, 3 days a week. And so I typically, or my typical response rate is 28 a week calls saying, hey, what you got? What do you want to talk about?
And what do you want to talk about?
That's a very good question because that was one of my limiting beliefs when I started it. I'm like, oh my God, Michael, well, what do I talk about when they call? And he's like, you know, he gives me this slew of things. For me right now, so for instance, this morning, I was talking to a KW colleague in my office, who is also a personal friend. And so she called me and said, hey, so I'm calling you from the PS on your note. By the way, I write her a note like every week. She's turned out to be one of my closest friends. And I said, well, I'm so glad you called. Are you aware of Mark King's initiative? I'm not really even supposed to talk about this. I shouldn't use this as an example, but too bad. So, well, sorry about that. That's pretty silly. I signed a non-disclosure and here I am disclosing it. So Keller, we're going to be in partnership with Keller Mortgage. There are about 40 agents that will be starting our own mortgage company. We're the guinea pig. So Mark King is our president, for those of you that don't know, and he is the operating principal at several of the market centers that I'm an owner in. So we get to work really closely with him and he's really committed to agents. So anyway, all of these opportunities come to you. So I already own a mortgage company, a title company. I own 11 businesses. And so these opportunities are super, super huge. And so I pass those opportunities on to others. When the opportunity is presented to me, I'm like, how many people can I bring with me? What's the investment? What is this? And I keep it really simple. That's about it. I don't need to see the prospectus. I don't need to do any of that. This is all just passive income opportunity. Somebody else is running it. You put some seed money in, you make your money back in less than a year, and then it's pure profit. Again, remember, I'm almost 60. So that's a really important thing for me, passive income with the wealth that we do have, creating more wealth. So anyway, a mortgage opportunity. So I ask, how many people can I bring along? And they're unlimited amount. Great. So when Kathy calls me, I said, hey, do you have some extra money to invest in passive income right now? And she said, no. So that was the end of that. But had she said yes, I would have told her about the mortgage opportunity and put her in touch with the person that's spearheading it for the greater Heartland region, of which I'm a part. What region are you guys in? I don't even know.
Oklahoma.
Are you great? Are you? Well, that's not a region.
It is.
Well, I don't think it's a region. Is that Stephanie?
Yes, it's a little.
Okay,
region,
great.
But we're our own.
Is that because of Mo?
Yeah.
Like we have our own region because we're the Mo Anderson region. Okay, cool. That's awesome. That is awesome. Much more manageable than ours. I thought you might be part of ours, but I don't even know. That's way above my pay grade, by the way. I just take advantage of opportunities. So anyway, the PS on my card was, call me. I have an idea to talk about. And so when she called, that's what I talked about. If I don't know what I want to talk about, I'm like, hi, are you coming to the cookie exchange? If I don't, you know, I mean, let's do lunch. I want to share some ideas with you. Let's, whatever the case may be, it's pretty simple. I will say, write it down. What are the opportunities that you could talk to people about? So I don't do that anymore, but I did the first 3 or 4 years I was doing this, is what are the opportunities I could talk to people about? So you could just keep it super simple and say, listen, we haven't done lunch in a while. Let's do lunch. I do events, a lot of events. I'm an event coordinator as one of my streams of income. And so literally I'm like, are you coming to this event? And then I have them on my database and basically pull up, what's the next event? Are you coming to Wine Down Wednesday? And they're like, I wasn't thinking about it. And I would be like, well, I really want to introduce you to Missy and Stephanie, and they're planning to be there. So if you can't come this month, will you consider coming next month? So again, don't overthink it, but think about it enough that you have something to say when people do begin calling you back. Because if you waste people's time, they will not take your call or call you back. Can we agree on that?
Yes.
No, I'm wasting Missy's time. She's leaving. Bye, Missy. Anyway, so seriously, give it enough thought that you know what you're going to say, but not so much thought that you're getting ready to get ready to get ready to get ready, which is an ailment that a lot of realtors have.
Yeah, they won't write the note because they don't know what to talk about.
Correct. So understand, literally, it could be like, hey, I'm getting some friends together for coffee next week. Would you like to join us? You know, so some high-minded individuals, here's what we'll usually talk about. I mean, again, do not overthink it. Any questions about that?
Man, I think you covered it. So opportunity three is the social media comments.
Yep.
I'm sure they're all political, right?
Totally. And we talk about death and medical issues and absolutely no. You know, so are you kidding me? I put those people on hiatus. You know, do not talk about politics on social media. What are you thinking? We're in sales. We need to be nice to everyone. And if that offends you, tough shit. You know, so give me a break. You know, we're not stupid. So literally our job in public is to be friendly to everyone as salespeople. So please don't forget that. What you do in private, it's probably more up to you. But I'm not sure that's a good idea to begin with, is to have any kind of strong predilection on polarizing ideas. But,
so
the comments are as simple as what I said, the pink dress on the cruise. A lot of the cards that I send, if they are not this, it's all three are intertwined. That's why I kind of keep going back and forth. I also have a system whereby I can load cards with pictures from social media and send those to folks, because people will never throw away a card that has their picture on it.
Okay, so you actually, you download a picture from their social media and then you create as a postcard and then you send it to them?
Yes.
Okay. And do you have a resource for that? Or do you?
I do, but I don't really advocate for it. There's many, many systems. Send out cards is one of them. Mailbox Power is another. I don't know. Probably everybody in the room uses a different system. But do keep in mind the key there is people never throw away a photo of themselves.
So what do you put on the back of the card so it doesn't come off as kind of creepy that you just stole from their picture?
So what do you put on the back of the card so that it doesn't come off a little creepy that you just stole a picture off of their Facebook and sent it to them?
Okay, so I'm trying to think of how to put this nicely. Because I'm in DC, so I'm not always politically correct. Nobody's really judging you. And if they are, I will say this. So we put these roadblocks in front of ourselves so that we don't have to do it, whatever it is. Let's talk about taking a photo off of Facebook and putting it on a card. It's a celebration, usually. This isn't like, you know, it's not their husband in bed at the hospice dying. You're not going to put that on a card. It's typically a celebration. Like right now, people are posting things with their family on Facebook around holiday parties and different celebrations. So it's typically a celebration, a milestone celebration. And so I've never had anyone think that was creepy. And if they did, they certainly didn't tell me about it. And I know it's not creepy. That's not where my mind goes. So just do it.
I use AM cards, and I do download their pictures from Facebook a lot. And every single one I've sent out that had the pictures, I promise you, every single one of thank you, how special it was.
It is so sweet. So I've tried to, even when we're at events, now that we're back out and around other people again, I try to take pictures with other people regularly. So like Missy was in St. Louis with Fizbo. That's hilarious, by the way. I still cannot, that comes out of my mouth and I just crack up. But, and Freddie Mac stayed home and, you know, so what? Anyway, so those, we took pictures together. I don't love the way I look in pictures or even in person, frankly, but it's very, very important, especially if you can tie that. So like at family reunion, I probably take 500 pictures. heck, I used to have a photographer with me. It's like, I don't do that anymore. But, you know, because you have a business that kind of rock and rolls on its own, you can stop doing some of the things that you used to spend money on. But literally document what you're doing with other people. Take pictures with other people that are meaningful to you, or take their pictures off of Facebook. And was that Stephanie that said you take pictures off Facebook?
No, that was one of our agents.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I'm telling you, nobody thinks it's creepy. It's kind of like going back to, you think if you say thank you too many times, that people will be like, stop saying thank you. I've never in my entire existence had someone say, stop saying thank you. Ever.
That's okay.
You know, we go, oh, what if you talk to this? I talk to my stager every week. I talk to my title people every week. I send them a card every week. I bring them gifts every week. I go really deep with just the people that are most important to me.
That's huge. Okay, so you said earlier that you go a lot deeper than you do wide. You make the 25 calls 3 times a week. Approximately, if you don't mind me asking, approximately how many people wide do you have? Because you're going so deep, and a lot of these you're calling repetitively. So is it like roughly 100 people or 500 people that you're making calls to over the course of a year? Or is there any specific strategy to that?
No, there's no strategy at all.
Whoever pops in your mind that day?
Yep. So that's the keep it simple part too. So I have a pretty wide reach, but I would say my focus is on less than 50 people.
Okay.
Probably 25, by the way, but that sounds really weird, doesn't it? So it is huge. It is just really, really, really focused. And that 25 or 50 people changes, by the way. It's kind of like friendships. Sometimes you'll have a very deep friendship with someone, and then circumstances change, things change, people can move, lots of different things happen, right? And so expecting that you're going to have a deep friendship with one person for the rest of your life may or may not be true. We all have a number of really close friends, and then we have a lot of acquaintances. Is that a fair statement?
Yes.
So it's the same thing here. It's not always the same people. It's not always the same 50. You know, I'd say it's the same 40, and then the 10 kind of are interchangeable. People come and go. I mean, I'm getting to an age where people are starting to retire, different things like that. So
is Missy part of the 40 or the 10?
Oh, she's not even in the mix.
Oh!
I'm just kidding. So she would definitely be in the 50. So I probably shouldn't tell you this. I mean, Missy has been responsible for probably 17 closings for me this year.
Wow. You get the purple letters. That's part of her.
What does that mean?
Missy, you said
the envelope.
Yep. Okay, well, thank you so much. Thank you so much for sharing. Any kind of closing thoughts?
Can she talk about leverage a little bit?
Yep.
Just for a few minutes.
How have you leveraged so well?
So I have to say, I just really keep it simple, and I know exactly where my focus is, and that's I'd rather be home with my family at all times. I'm always looking for opportunities to impact people's lives and come from contribution, but I do keep it pretty short. So let me go back to the 25 calls. They're literally 30 seconds apiece. No joke. I mean, it truly, truly takes less than an hour and a half every day. So don't overcomplicate it. Leverage for me is I'm a solo agent, sort of. I have a virtual assistant and two on-call showing assistants. And by on-call, it means if I'm overloaded, I call them to help. So they're not paid for me. They're not on payroll. I don't have any, they don't have any benefits. It's none of these people do. So I'm an individual agent. I run 10, I have 10 streams of income. I run 7 business specifically. So the keep it simple and leverage is very important. Here's a real kicker. Are you ready? Yeah. I actually let the title company do their work. I actually let the mortgage person do their work. I let my team leader, so I have over $1 million in profit share in the last 17 years. And so I let the team leader recruit people that I put them in touch with. I don't get involved with that other than thank you. You know, I've been telling my team leader what a great co-op agent you were. I've really enjoyed working with you, and promise me you'll take his call. That's directly from Mo Anderson, my very first ALC clinic, you know, in my first year with Keller Williams Realty St. Louis. And so use those things, utilize people's skill sets, let them do the heavy lifting. Mostly that's our ego, by the way. We want to be good at everything. I'm not really very good at much, but I am surrounded by people who are really good, really, really good at what they do. And I let them do their jobs.
So trusting the people, putting the right people in place, and as
yes,
co-op to the transaction, let them do that.
You cut out. I'm not exactly sure what you said. Sorry.
Yeah, just not. It's good. I'm just kidding. No, just empowering the people that you're already working with. That's
exactly right. Let them do their job. Like I tell, can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay, sorry, but I think my AirPods are running low. But anyway, so just raise your hand if for some reason I'm cutting out. But let the people that you are surround yourself with the best, and then let them do their jobs. I literally am like, lose my number. Only let me know if there's a problem that I need to be involved in. If there's a problem and you're taking care of it, there's a reason I call our processor Amazing Amanda, literally. If I refer something to another agent, they want to keep you updated the whole time. I'm like, wait, that's not my client. It's your client now. And I didn't know them to begin with. And I definitely don't need to be updated because I don't know that person. You do. And it's your new client and good luck and you're fabulous and all that good stuff. But I don't need to be kept updated. I love you. I will keep sending you people that don't meet my business model. You know, rock on with your bad self. It's, you know, just let people do their jobs. And I find that we are micromanagers. I don't tend to be a micromanager. I just take really good ideas and run with them and then usually make them better. So that would definitely be a talent that I have. It's like, dang, that worked well. Well, how do we 10 plus that? 10 times that, whatever.
Have you noticed as you've been around other successful people that is a common trait of empowering the people around them and trusting the people that they empower?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, and so this will be familiar to one person in the room. It's like, you know, slow to hire, quick to fire. You know, make sure you are surrounding yourself with the right people. And then when you find that they're not the right people, people grow in different directions. I'm very good at very kindly letting people move on to something that's a better, higher use of their time without harming relationships. And so, you know what? It's all in your mindset and how you speak to people. It's very, very important. Very, very important. And it's learned over time. You know, I'm not young and I used to be kind of an asshole, but not so much anymore.
Was it the gratitude calls that changed that?
No. I have really great parents and I have an amazing husband. I will tell you what, you know, but those 5 cards that I send to his office 5 times a week, literally every morning, they're already self-addressed. They're already stamped. They're already addressed. I do all 365 for the entire year. It's that important to me. So I send him hundreds a year. And it buys me a lot of grace. So like when I'm not the nicest or I have expectations or whatever. So literally he had lunch door dashed to me today because my back hurts. So that's what it gets you. It's like, wow. I mean, he's just an incredible, incredible person. But I would say everyone in my life is. So it's a little bit of a common theme, huh?
Isn't it funny how, like, when you what you focus on expands? When you mm-hmm. focus on finding something to be grateful for in someone, you just yep. find people that are great, that you're grateful for all the time.
Law of attraction.
Yep. It's unbelievable. And then you're surrounded by, so like, I remember when I first met Missy and she and Steve, yeah, I just, gosh, the memories are incredible and the growth and the incredible trajectory and contributor that you have in your office there. It's just, it's really something. And so I often am like, wow, how am I a part of these people's lives? I really don't get it, but okay. Yay, I'm in. I don't know. And so, you know, surround yourself with the people that you, this was a big Missy thing. Oh my goodness, man, Missy didn't have any problem calling anyone, no matter, I mean, she'd call Gary Keller, I think, and he'd probably answer. And so Missy would call all of these power players. And then suddenly she was like their close personal friend. I watched this happen. It was just so cool. I don't really know how to explain that. I don't think it's no fear. I think it's abundance. We are in a company where you could pick up the phone and call anyone of the, you know, 170, however many thousand of us there are. And so do that. My closest friends are people who just picked the phone up and said, hey, I think I need to know you. And I'm like, really? How come? Why? You know, and I think that's ballsy and I have a lot of guts and I'm a real go-getter. And so that's really interesting to me when people do that. Any of you call me, I will spend a half hour talking to you. I can go into more depth about the things. I mean, I have a million things I could talk to you about. So the last thing that I definitely want to say is contribution is so, so key, you guys. So I'm in the top 2% of realtors in St. Louis, and I work part-time-ish. I don't know if you can really say that. I have my fingers in a lot of pies. I'm a cultural ambassador more than once for our Greater Heartland Eagle Award. I win it like every other year. I mean, it's just about contributing to other people. This year, I've done 57 incoming referrals and almost 500 outgoing referrals. So I make more money from outgoing referrals than I do all of my closings put together. It's just contribute to other people. Figure just one thing, by the way, just one thing, not whatever you heard today, just one, pick one thing and be willing to implement it this week. One thing. So the one thing that's really important to me is my family. The second thing is travel. So I have 63 days of travel scheduled for the first half of 2022. That's really important to me. We're scuba divers. And so, and by the way, I'm on a boat. So literally I'm not taking calls.
That's awesome. So and you said 60, you already got 60 what days?
63.
63 days in the first half. Yeah, up through June.
Yeah,
that's a highly leveraged person. Any other
questions? Here's the thing. No, but here's the thing. If I can do it, you can do it. That's why I say that, by the way. I'm super special. Yeah, not, you know, just use your time well. What's important to you? Focus, go deep. Most of us do such shallow work that you're like a hamster on a wheel. And so I promise if you go deeper, it's much more enjoyable and a lot more fun. Got to go deep with the right people, but.
Any questions? All right. This has been great. This has been helpful.
Yeah. Thank you. And thank you.
You are, oh my gosh, the lights are on.
Yes.
That's so funny. Well, thank you for having me. And so who is the brain, whose brainchild was Talk About It Tuesday?
Taylor's.
Taylor. Holy cow. All right, Missy, will you send me Taylor's contact information? Because I don't even know who Taylor is. Sorry, are you the ATL? Are you, the, I don't know, are you Agent Services? No, no, I know what you look like. I know what you do.
I'm actually just a career development committee on my ALC. So I'm an agent in the office.
Dude, oh my God. That is impressive. So, well, I don't remember what I was going to say now, but anyway, thank you, Taylor. That's really impressive. That's, you're a true contributor, and I know everybody in the room appreciates and is now going to give you a standing ovation and clap for you. That's awesome. And thank you, Stephanie. And I love you, Missy.
Thank you so much. Bye. I appreciate you so much.
Bye.
Orlando.
Yeah, see you at family reunion.